Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now, two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Eagles going up against the Saints. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
First opened back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the Philadelphia Eagles and the New Orleans Saints. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest, you'll take the week off, get your guys up a little bit in red.
Who will punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round? We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. And leading them out there, their 6'5 quarterback. They come out here in the eye. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a little jumpy there defensively. Ref caught him in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll run now with Ware. Stays on his feet. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
They run again with Ware. They find some open field here. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
And that's how you get started and open up a game. Really well-blocked play. Picked up a nice chunk of yardage. If you're the offensive line, that's exactly what you've talked about all week long in your meetings. Establish the line of scrimmage and take control. And they gave their running back plenty of room to rumble.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. A gain of three, second down. And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he can turn it into a big play at any time.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he hits his man, Matthews. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, We see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And he is going to lose yardage here.
Holding offense.
So holding by the offense, and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. It'll be a gain of four, and it'll make this a second and long. As we get a look at the defensive starters, the secondary, they're certainly going to need to be on their toes in this one.
And you know me really well. Where do I start analyzing a game? From the secondary. And these guys have to be on point today. They're facing a high-powered attack.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. The gun. They'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Second down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a third and one.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
First down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Benny Logan in there on the tackle.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to bring up a third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play, but you know there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Play clock winding down. Out of the gun now on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect them. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Getting sent to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something.
There we go! One, nine.
They go back to the air here after the INT. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
They give him 12 yards and a first down. So it'll be first down here after the run. One quarter gone in this NFC divisional round matchup. Nothing-nothing our score. We'll head back to New Orleans after this. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And bringing it in, this is Salek over the middle. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
This one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. But winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
He lost four there, and it's third down.
Partner, we're into the second quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you got going on. The only concern you have, if you get to the half, what adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you?
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Finds his target, Montgomery. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? the better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Down to the 25. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Ertz has it left side. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players and somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
On the run, it's Ware. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down. And the 2-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Ty Montgomery, a 7. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
This is Ingram. And an alley to run. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
And that's why defense coordinators always preach 11 guys to the ball. Because sometimes you have a missed tackle, but if you have a swarm of guys around, less room for him to roam even after the first missed tackle. In this case, tackle was missed. Plenty of open field to get after that.
Now it's Ingram, and he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll bring up a second in just about a few inches here.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Back to throw now on first down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Thomas, the intended target, and it's second down. Offense still needing 10 yards, second down.
Check.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Fletcher Cox in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Fletcher Cox in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they? A dime? What were
they? 15 cents.
So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Saints have controlled the flow, but it hasn't given them a big advantage. The Eagles won't care how much their offense is on the field as long as they find a way to advance in these playoffs. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Eagles take it at the 49. Here the pass is completed into coverage, and he'll be tackled at the 36-yard line. Eagles wind up throwing a pick on the drive. Set up now, 3rd and 7. Montgomery's by himself here, and he caps off the long drive with a touchdown. Eagles is up now by 7. 1st and 10, Ingram's gonna dart up the middle. He'll pick up more than 10 yards on the play. So that's all for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll get you back out to the field now for some more playoff action.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And now working their way back onto the field, the Eagles defense. They had a pretty solid first half. Not many adjustments, but I guess there's probably always some adjustments that can be made.
Usually it's just tightened down on the things we've worked on all week in practice. Everyone thinks adjustments are bringing in something absolutely new. For the most part, it's tweaks or just emphasizing what you've worked on already. And that's what they're planning to do here in the second half.
Yeah, they won't be looking to reinvent the wheel. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's going to want, and this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, New Orleans. Brandon Cooks, 64 yards. And the Saints have taken the lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. That's almost like one of your Turkey Bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. breaks through, and that makes the lead 10-7. They certainly made quick work of that, ultra-quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see. Just one play resulting in the touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them.
They'll try and start this drive in the air, and that's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. That'll bring up second down.
This has been a really nice day for the defense. They've made it so difficult to find open receivers because they're able to squeeze the passing lanes down. A lot of what they're doing is communicating. Receivers in one area, receivers in another area. They're almost what they call passing them off from one defender to the next, even in zone defenses, and making it very hard to find an open spot for the quarterback to deliver the ball. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Out of the gun now on third down. He's going to let it go again. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Here's Tim Mastay now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll try to get the ground game going with Ingram. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
But we all know the guy carrying the ball is going to get the credit both in the stat line and probably in the newspaper. But guess what? Those guys creating holes, they couldn't feel better about themselves right now. Offensive line, tight end, probably even the wide receivers are involved. They're moving the ball well.
And the play clock's running down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And it's caught, Kobe Flaner. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Has it. And now off to the races, down the right. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Holding offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
After the penalty, it's Ingram. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. Second down following the run. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Looking to throw. That's complete. It's Gordon. And he's brought down after a good game. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Here we go now. Green, 39. Over. Gun. Detroit. Leopard.
They'll need to get the playoffs quickly. He'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Take this one down to the 36. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. Out here on the play clock. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he'll go down at the 28. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Down, he'll drop to throw. It's complete. Fleener, right side. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. In the red zone this time. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
Play clock winding down. They'll run here with Ingram. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Mark Ingram, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. And there you go, nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Extra point attempt to follow here. here. It's good to make it 17-7. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it's Mark Ingram who caps it off with a touchdown run. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And on the last goal. Well, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had the punt.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And this is Ertz with it, right side. 15 yards there on the catch and run. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Hey, four down. Come on, let's go!
Back to throw here. And bringing it in, this is Salek over the middle. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. 3 yards to go here on second down. They run it here. Where? And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So the offense has it first and 10. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. And now here's a carry heading left. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. One receiver left, 2 to the right.
Come on, let's go!
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a 3rd down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Third down and 3.
Let's go! Ryan 38! Ryan 38!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Spencer Ware, the intended target. And it's 4th down. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. Oh, they to get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember.
Those really long field goals, when they are made, they are things of beauty. But there is a danger to getting them started, isn't there?
Yeah, with that low drive, you've got to really keep it low to the ground, don't you, to get that distance.
Yeah, hard to just pop it up in the air because otherwise it's not going to get there. So he's got to drive it low in order to have the distance, and that usually puts it in jeopardy, gives him a chance to block it, and everyone knows it.
He's down to about the 40. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. They come up with one back. That's Ingram. And he'll get it up the middle. And he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a 1st down here on 3rd down. Set up to throw. It's complete to Planter. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
And that pickup of a 1st down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
And the play clock's running down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Working his way for a gain of 7 to the 26. Productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a 3rd down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there and swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
It's not always as trite as that team wanted it more than the other, but on that play, it actually was true. They were faster to the ball.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. And his kick is good. And that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with 3.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position?
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Now he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. Haole Kikaha in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. In a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic, this is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. The gun. They'll look to throw. Well, this is Montgomery with a grab over the middle. That catch good for five. It's third down. And right now, defensively, you love that, don't you? I mean, you'll give them that play.
And they'll take it every single time. This is almost like nickeling and diming it downfield, and too much time's going to run off the clock.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now really hoping for a turnover. They come up in an offset eye. Here's Ingram. No gain on the play there. Second down. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout.
Double tight, guys. Double tight. Four down. Four down. Check, check.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
Now Ingram. He's been busy today. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. The offense got the ball in a good spot, but they went nowhere. They settled for three.
Brandon, I think it's safe to say that was a major disappointment. Had a great opportunity, excellent field position, and to not be able to move the ball at all, big time letdown.
This is taken at the three. Oh, spinning away. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. A good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be third down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And able to complete it to Green Beckham. The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. They go play action here on first down. Ertz has it left side. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it'll be a Philadelphia first down. And quickly, they get to the line. And with the clock ticking under 50 seconds now, he spikes it. So second and 10 here. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start, offense.
Back to throw again. Caught by Montgomery. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play. And it'll be a third and about 13. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Now a and he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
And there's the touchdown that they needed, so they'll celebrate, but the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick. They'll try and throw for it, and that one is caught. So they convert here, and don't look now, but this one's back to a one-score game. And now we've got a one-score game and at least a little light at the end of the tunnel.
Is that what we call a glimmer of hope?
Glimmer of hope.
Because they've got to get an onside kick and then find their way into the end zone before time expires. Glimmer, or what's less than a glimmer?
I don't know. You're the one that knows all the big words. A sparkle? A sparkle.
Yeah, there we go. That's what we're going with.
We put our attention now on the Eagles' defense. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Baltimore.
Crab cakes will be waiting for us, partners. We head to the airport.
Heck yeah.